Hey, Leo.
Hey, Trey.
You.
So what do you want to talk about? Besides, we'll plug the DVD, of course.
Well, we could talk about photography. We could talk about
well, of course, photography.
Revelation.
Do you want to talk about that new Canon SD95?
Oh, I don't know enough about it to talk about it intelligently.
It's getting a lot of attention.
I'm still researching it.
Yeah, okay. When you do know more about it, I'd love to get your opinion, because everybody's going crazy as if like this is like the God camera, which I never really thought of it that way. But.
Yeah, I really want to research it thoroughly before I can
talk good.
With any elegance about it.
Well, pick a topic.
Okay, we can talk about how about we just stick with the old HDR photography? That's easy.
You know that one. Why don't we talk about, because we kind of got cut off on this, what cameras would be best for HDR? Can you make a couple of recommendations?
Yeah, absolutely.
I think we did talk about it, but I don't know if we got it on the air.
Sure.
All right, here
Am
we go.
I video, by the way?
No, start your video.
Okay, here we go. Video. Video.
Yeah, billboard is DSL Extreme, and the live read is Carbonite BTS.
This portion of the Tech Guy Show is brought to you by my internet service provider, DSL Extreme. For high-speed internet at an amazingly low price, call 866, the number 2, GetNet, to get DSL Extreme. Leo Laporte, the tech guy, talking about technology as we always do at this time. And I'm really pleased to welcome back a guy who was such a hit on the show when he was on a few weeks ago. Talking about high dynamic range photography, or HDR photography, Trey Ratcliffe of StuckInCustoms.com. And welcome back, Trey.
Thanks, Leo. How are you?
I'm great. Nice to see you again. And one of the reasons I wanted to get you back is when you were on, you talked about the fact that you were doing a DVD on how to do HDR. You have a great free tutorial on your website already, StuckInCustoms.com. But now there's a full DVD for people. And I'm buying this, by the way, because I bought Photomatix, the program that you recommended, and I've made some really ugly HDR photos, and I'm ready for some instructions, so I'm going to get the DVD. StuckInCustoms.com, right?
That's right, StuckInCustoms.com, and you can find all about the DVD there. In fact, I wanted to give a coupon code to your fans and fans of Leo, if that's okay.
Please do. Are you kidding?
Sure. So, if you want 20% off, just go type in Leo Loves HDR.
Well, you're making some big assumptions there, aren't you? I love HDR.
It's great stuff. It's about 6 hours of instruction, and basically I tell you how to take what comes out of Photomatix and all these other programs and then make it beautiful, because that's really Photomatix, I see, is sort of a first step to the final creation.
It's pretty automatic, but if you let it do just what it does, and I don't really understand tone mapping or anything, I just press a few buttons, you're going to get some, well, maybe not the best looking images ever. So here's a great HDR that you took on your site, StuckInCustoms.com, of me in the studio. That's an HDR, right?
Yeah, that's an HDR. And actually, those are the kind of HDRs I like, where people look at them and they're not sure if it's an HDR or not.
Yeah, see, my stuff you knew.
You got to watch out, because, you know, once you cross the Rubicon into HDR trippy land, there's no return.
Yeah.
So you kind of want to stay in that hinterland in between fantasy and reality, to something that's beautiful and just you can't quite put your finger on what you love about it.
I actually, you know, the one that I made, which was of a beautiful garden when we dropped my daughter off at college, I pushed it all the way. They have a setting called Painterly, and it made it look, like you said, unreal.
So the problem with that HDR is I see these problems all the time.
Well, one is the sky, and I know you talked about, you've got a halo problem there. Yeah, you got to fix the sky. You said that.
That's an issue. So the other thing that Photomatix does, and a lot of these algorithms do, is they overamp the green. So,
yeah. And you know, since there was a lot of green in the picture, that really overamped.
Well, here's the counterintuitive thing, Leo, that what you're seeing in that photo is it's not too green, it's actually too yellow.
Oh.
And really, biomass is translucent, and you're getting a lot of the sunlight through there, which becomes yellow. If you take that into Photoshop and pull up hue saturation and turn on the green and you desaturate the green, you'll see hardly any change to your photo at all. But if you take it to the yellow and desaturate the yellow, then it will look a lot more natural.
I do like the effect. I mean, look, admittedly, it's kind of a freaky looking photo, but I love how it makes it look
cool.
Like
it's very cool.
Yeah.
Especially when it's big and your eye actually has to physically travel around the photo for you to appreciate it, because that's what your eye does on the scene.
Right.
If you try to take in all those light levels at once, your brain might reject it because it feels unrealistic.
So I wanted to ask you, so again, go to stuckincustoms.com. That's Trey's site. There are lots of great HDR photos there. There's a free tutorial there. You can get an idea of how to take these images and create them. If I may thumbnail it, the idea is that your eye is capable of seeing a much broader range of light and dark than your camera is. So these HDR photos, you take a number of shots in a number of different exposures and then combine them using software so that the picture looks something more like what your eye would see than what your camera can see. The dark, you see more in the dark, more in the light.
Yeah, well said. You got it.
and Trey does such a good job with these. They I know that you aren't trying to make them look like HDR, but they always do look a little bit magical. My studio never looked quite so magical, I must say. So what I wanted to ask, anyway, go to Stuck in Customs. You can see these images. You can use this free tutorial. And if you decide to get the video, use the coupon code LeoLovesHDR. How much are they, was it, how much off?
Well, it's 20% off.
Wow,
there's
nice.
Two packages. There's a basic and a premium. So if you want all the goodies, get the premium. But if you're, you know, on a budget and just want to get the basics, get the basic package. But you save 20% on both with
Thank
your
you.
Code
That's
either
nice.
Way.
I'm going to do that right after I get off the air. So the question I wanted to ask, and one of the questions we kept getting after you were on the show a couple of weeks ago, is I want to do this. I have a point-and-shoot camera. Can I do this with my point-and-shoot camera? What cameras do you recommend if people want to do this?
Well, I have a list of recommendations on the page. There are hundreds of cameras that can do this, but rather than overwhelm people with the hundreds of combinations and permutations, I do have some basic suggestions. Now, if you already have a camera and don't want to buy a new one, which is usually the case, if your camera can do something called auto-bracketing, then you're great. You're in the money. If it can instead just shoot raw files, then you're also okay. Now, having said all that, if you're about to get a camera and you want to do this look, you can get into the game for less than $500. The low end entry level camera that I recommend is the Canon G11. Which is strange because I'm really a Nikon shooter, but this is a great, very inexpensive way in. Another great low-end camera is the LX3, which will probably have a nice price drop soon because there's a new one of those coming out. So those are two great entry-level ones. And then I have upgrades from there if you're interested.
The Canon G11, these are point-and-shoots, and the
right.
Lumix from Panasonic, the Lumix LX3, also point-and-shoot, both shoot RAW. So you said RAW is one way to do this. You don't even have to do bracketing if you can get a good RAW image.
That's right.
And if you have a camera that will do bracketing, that is take multiple exposures, you know, half a stop down, just right, and half a stop up. Or, you know, I was taking on my Panasonic G&H1, I think it was seven images a third of a stop apart. Is that way too much?
Yes.
That's when you get an image like that, Trey.
No. What you should try to do is step by one or step by two.
One or two stops apart, and how many images?
Ideally, you want to go from +2 to -2 with three total exposures. So if you can step by two, you have a +2 exposure, which means it's very bright, but the shadows are well represented.
Yeah.
You want to have a 0, that's the normal exposure, and the -2, which is quite dark, but all those bright spots will have nice texture and realistic areas. And this is, of course, what you see with your eye when you're there.
So I was taking 7 images, way too many.
Well, your steps were a little too small.
Too small.
There's not that much difference, and it's too much process. It doesn't hurt to do all those extras. It really doesn't hurt. It's just extra processing time and just sort of a little bit of a waste.
Photomatics didn't complain, so I was okay.
No.
Trey Ratcliffe is such a great guy at explaining photography. I would love to do more with you, Trey. So let's get you back on the show on a semi-regular basis, talking about photography, cool. Talking about not just HDR but other things too. You're just one of my favorite photographers. And the picture you took of the front of the Twit Cottage, which is on the page. I don't think that's an HDR. I don't think so.
No, that's taken with a Nikon D3S. That's a 50mm prime lens.
It's beautiful.
And it's a 1.4 lens, but I shot that at f/5.3 because if you're to shoot that at a lower number, like a 1.4, then the Twit Cottage sign that lists out your shows there, it would be unreadable.
Too blurry.
Because it'd be too blurry.
Right. But it's a little blurry, which gives it a nice focus on the flowers in the foreground. Yeah.
That's right. A little bit of depth, but not too much. You don't want to, make it too arty so that it loses all of its relevance.
That's what I did wrong. It was too arty. I'm too arty. Trey Ratcliffe is at stuckitcustoms.com. That's where you can see his pictures, his images. The tutorial is free on the website, but he also has a DVD now. And if you use the coupon code Leo Loves HDR, right? You'll get
That's
20%
right.
off. And I don't get a cut of that. That's just Trey doing that out of the goodness of his heart. Trey, we'll have you back real soon.
Yes, sir.
Thanks for joining us. Trey Ratcliffe, everybody. What a nice guy. He's one of the nice guys in the business. That's what I like. Just gives stuff away and is such a good photographer. Hey, if you are in photography,
come back with more.
Leo Laporte, the tech guy. Thanks, Trey. He's wandering through his house. We're taking a trip with Trey through the magic of Skype. Where are you going, Trey?
I'm going back to my little office. See my 30-inch monitors there?
Oh, man. What kind do you use and recommend? Do you like the Apple ones? Or?
Yeah, you got to get the Apple ones.
How do I protect my PC from...
They're the best.
For color gamut and accuracy?
Yeah, color gamut. And, actually, they all come off the same assembly line. You probably know this. And then Apple and Samsung get the first picks. But it's all the same thing.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
So is Samsung your second choice?
Yeah, the Samsung one is great, but if you're going to get two, they should be the same monitor exactly because it's too hard to calibrate them otherwise.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. What about the high-priced Ezio monitors? They claim to have even better gamut and so forth, but they're really expensive.
Well, I don't know. That's a good question. I've never used those or even seen them.
Yeah, Ray, you know what? That's one. When we do it, we're going to do a podcast, I swear, and we're going to do it with Ray. We're going to do it with Lisa, with you, and I want it to be a how-to podcast. Not like This Week in Photography, which is enthusiasts getting together to discuss, enthusiast issues, but like down and dirty, how to do stuff, how to make your own, a practical show. Lisa's like how to make your own lights out of cheap hardware, stuff like that.
Yeah.
But anyway, we'll get Ray on because Ray could be the science guy and he'll explain to us which
I love Ray. If I don't watch out, I'll just run off on all these wild tangents with Ray.
That's okay. That's why our shows are 2 hours long.
That guy knows about everything.
I know. He's so great. Well, I know you're anxious to do it, and I am anxious to do it, too. It's, we have a limited amount of bandwidth to start new shows, and, we're in the middle of getting three shows launched. As those get settled in, and we're hiring some more producers, we're hiring some more editors, once they get settled in, then I think we'll be ready. I think I already talked to our ad agency, and they say, I said, can you sell a photography show? They said, can we sell a photography show? So definitely there would be some demand for it.
Sure, no rush. It's a good idea now. It's a good idea later. When it is what it is, and it'll happen when it happens.
Good.
Sounds great.
Yeah. Soon, though. I'm hoping by September.
Okay.
Fun. Thanks, Trey. Great to have you on. Sure. I'll send you a note, and maybe every couple of weeks we'll get you back on.
All right. Sounds great.
Okay. Take care.
Take it easy.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.